So last video we saw the cap theorem. What is this and what is the extension? What is the criticism? So let's see the questions that we can expect in the interviews around this one. First question is what is cap theorem and why is it important? This is the basic question that you can get this answer from the previous video directly. No need much explanation into this one. Can you give an example of a system that prioritizes consistency and availability? And what trade-offs does this system make? This also covered in the previous one when we covered the examples of the different combinations. So banking is in a system that prioritizes consistency and availability. Network partition is the trade-off that it makes. It is possible to compromise that one because banking it works in a very closed network, so the chances of the network failures are very less. That is why it chooses the consistency and availability. Other factor is that why it chooses the consistency, because it is very important, because when you're depositing the money, it should make sure that it is replicated throughout its all the system before responding to the user with the success one. How do you design a system that prioritizes partition tolerance and availability? So to answer such questions, you just need to see this combinations examples and go ahead and see the system design of that. Here it is asking to prioritize partition tolerance and availability, where here the example is any social network site, Facebook, e-commerce, any e-com site that we can see, that the example. So I'll just guide you with the solutions that is, but the best one is to go to see and see the system design of that one. So what we can we have to when we have to choose between partition tolerance and availability, first is the storage system. We have to choose a storage system that is designed for this availability and partition tolerance. What is the example of this one? Apache Cassandra is there, such example which prioritizes partition tolerance and availability over consistency. Use some techniques such as replication and load balancing to distribute the network workloads across the multiple nodes that are there. Replication is necessary so that it is made consistent over the time when there is a latency. We have to prioritize that one. We have to implement the error handling and retry mechanism properly so that if there is a failure in one try, it can retry for others. We have to properly use the monitoring and alerting tools to detect the errors that happened and to fix that on time. The next question is what other trade-offs should you consider when designing distributed systems beside the trade-offs between consistency, availability, and partition tolerance? While covering the extension of the cap theorem, we have talked about this one. What are those? Those are latency, security is another thing, scalability is another thing, cost, what is the cost of the implementation is another thing, and development complexity. It should not be there that considering the cap only and you make the system too complex. That is also a trade-off that we consider while designing a real-time application. Next comes the scenario wise. You are building a distributed system for a social media platform that allows user to post updates and photos. What properties should you prioritize over according to the cap theorem and why? We have seen this in example. It is availability and partition tolerance. Consistency is the compromise that we do with this one. Second one is that you are building a distributed system for a banking application that allows users to transfer money between accounts. What properties should you prioritize according to the cap theorem? So we know this example. We have to go with the CA, consistency and availability. Next scenario is you are designing a distributed system for a logistic company that needs to track the location of the packages in real time. This is the important question. It is asking what trade-offs might you need to make according to the cap theorem, and how should you ensure that a system remains reliable even during network partition. First, it has asked the trade-offs that you will make to the cap theorem. Other requirement it has given that it should be remains available during the network partition. So it has given one priority that your system must remain available during network partition. So one is there, like you have to prioritize the availability is the first thing. This system is also very similar to the banking application, where consistency is very important. Availability, it has already told that it is important that our systems remains available. Network partitions in a logistic company less likely to occur because they work in a internal network only. So they compromise. In this scenario, the partition tolerance is compromised and consistency and availability is prioritized. The next question is, you are designing a distributed system for a healthcare application that needs to store patient records securely. What other factors besides the CAF theorem should you consider when designing these systems and why? So this thing we already have covered in one of the questions, but when it is talking about the patient records in a healthcare company, the privacy plays a very critical role. So the other factors comes to GDPR, which is a regulation where you need to delete the data after a certain point of time on request or automatically. Other thing is the fault tolerance, compliance, security, scalability. These things will come into account. Latency will come into account. Okay. So yeah, that was it about all the most of the questions and scenario wise questions. So try to relook the questions and see how much you can answer it. It will give you thorough understanding of the CAP theorem, its drawbacks and how to apply this one in the real time. So look for the more scenario wise question. It will give you the solid understanding and you will be able to discuss this properly with the interviewer. So I hope it gave you the clarity about this one. We'll see you in some other video on this one. Till then, take care. Bye bye.